It's the birthplace of college football. It's difficult to miss the huge statue of William Leggett outside SHI Stadium, like it was the captain of Rutgers football team when it took the field for the first college football game in the history of the sport. Rutgers faced the College of New Jersey, now Princeton University, on November 6, 1869. Rutgers won 6-4. To celebrate the 150th anniversary of college football, Rutgers theater students suited up and threw it back to the 1800s, reenacting the first game ahead of the university's first game of the 2019 season. Marshall Jones is professor of theater at Rutgers and directed the reenactment that took place at the Marco Battaglia practice complex.
Our goal is not to necessarily get the authentic, you know, game 150 years ago, but just to kind of capture the spirit.
And students were able to capture the essence of what it felt like to be at the first college football game through a number of ways, including clothing.
If we were to do an authentic reenactment, it would not be recognizable. There were 50 players. There were 25 on each side. It was more of a combination of rugby and soccer than football as we know it. So we tried to figure out how we can make this recognizable to today's audience. So there's 11-man squads. There is no forward pass because that wasn't invented yet. You know, it's a physical game. It's a physical game back then, and it's a physical game now. So it's a lot of tackling. The players would wrap like gauze around there to get elbow pads. They didn't have shoulder pads. They wrapped scarves around their heads.
My name is William J. Leggett, and I'm the captain of the Rutgers football team.
Meet Ryan Neely, a Rutgers Theater alum who plays the role of William J. Leggett. Neely describes him as a man looking to get a leg up on Princeton.
Rutgers had just gone through a pretty big loss to Princeton in baseball, 40-2. So Mr. Leggett and the other folks there at Rutgers were looking to get revenge.
Currently, I'm William Goodmare. I'm captain of the Princeton football team. I found out he went on to become a Chief Justice of the New Jersey Supreme Court.
Jones says actors were able to get a sense of who they were playing from past articles and news clippings. The fans on the sidelines also got into character.
Get up, lad! Get up!
You're better than that.
The fans in this time period are so important because they kind of represent the new generation. They're the beginning of football in schools. This is a typical outfit that they will wear in the 1800s.
The reenactment attracted fans of all ages, including alum Carol Krause. Krause and her late husband graduated Rutgers in 1961.
Our kids grew up coming to games, and we've had season tickets for football. When we were students here, we played Princeton every year that we were students. And since they played in the first game, it would have been nice had they agreed to play against Rutgers for the birthday.
Rutgers won that first game, and the current Scarlet Knights kicked off their season by defeating UMass 48-21. In Piscataway, Raven Santana, NJTV News.